Hello everyone, welcome back to Learn for Turkey. In this video, we are going to talk about Pipenv. What is Pipenv? Pipenv is a package management tool, Python package management tool, which is used to create and manage virtual environment for your projects. We can make use of it to install or uninstall dependencies. So instead of creating virtual environment ourselves using Python command, we can make use of Pipenv to create virtual environment for us automatically, and then we can use some simple commands, pipenv install, uninstall commands, etc., to manage our dependencies and then to get started with the Python project. So let's get on the VS Code and see how we can install pipenv and then make use of it to create a simple Python project. Let's get started. So I have VS Code open on my system. I have a Linux system, so we are going to see everything on the Linux system, and in the later videos we can cover up other operating systems. Okay, so what we have, you know, I have a pipenv.md file where I have listed down few commands which we will be following together. Okay, so first of all, those who do not have pipenv obviously needs to install pipenv, but we need to know what version of Python we are setting. It should be more than 3 of Python version. Okay, so first check the Python version using the command. So Python -- version. So here it is 3.12.6. Currently in my system, I am using pyenv to manage multiple Python version. Those who are unfamiliar with pyenv can check out my past video used on pyenv. Okay, how to install pyenv, how to make use of it to install or switch to a different version of Python. Okay, so I have Python 3.12.6. Now, what we have to do in order to install pipenv, we have to run this command pip install -- user pipenv. Now, what is this user means? In the system, can have more than one user, right? So if I'm logging to the Linux system, so I'm sitting on my current user profile, okay? So if I'm typing in --- user, the pipenv will get installed only for a particular user, only for me, right? So we will see where it gets installed, etc. So if you have a Python, you just have to type in this command and your pipenv will get installed. Since I have already run this command, so I have the pipenv in my system in this Python environment. Okay, so after running this command, if you have to start creating the Python project, what you need to do? So here I have a sample Python project, that is sample project. I've created a sample Python project with the name main.py is a file. In this main.py file, what we have written is very simple code. We have imported import request, which basically it is a request package which is used to invoke an API call. And then we have a URL. We are making use of the JSON placeholder, a free REST API endpoint to get the post. And then I'm just making a call using request.get URL. And ultimately parsing that response and printing it over the screen. This is a simple Python program. Now, if you want to run this Python program using pipenv, if you want to set this particular project environment using pipenv, what we need to do, let us see. First of all, I am already sitting in the sample project folder, so you need to switch to that particular folder. Let me clear the screen. Now, what command I need to type in to install request package? As you see in the VS Code, we have request as a yellow squiggly line. So what we need to do, we need to install this request package. Now, what command we need to type in? Python -m pipenv install request. Okay. So what is this Python -m mean? It means that you install this request package using the currently selected current Python version. Okay, current Python version, install this request package. Okay, as soon as I type in this command, what happened in pipenv? Pipenv automatically creates the virtual environment for us. Previously in the last video, we have seen that we have made use of conda, we have made use of Python command in order to create the virtual environment ourselves using venv. But here we are simply going to install a package, that's it. Then it will automatically create the virtual environment, but it will not create the virtual environment within this folder. It will only create the virtual environment in a different folder. We will see which folder it has installed. Basically, I have a different shell open, and let me show you like where it is going to install the virtual environment, where it is going to create the virtual environment. So home, my username, dot local, share, virtual envs. This is the folder. In your case, the username will be, as per your system, it will be different. Okay. So in this folder, it is going to create the virtual environment folder. And there in that folder, it is going to install the request package. So let us quickly run this command and hit enter. Now, what happened? It sees that whether the virtual environment is already there. If not, then let me just create it and install the packages over there. But if you have already created a virtual environment using venv, then it will make use of it. Okay, otherwise it will create it. Okay, sometimes people are already created the virtual environment, switched or activated that virtual environment, and then type in this command. In that case, pipenv won't create a virtual environment separately. It will make use of it. Otherwise, it will create it in this particular folder. If you see, in this particular folder, it has created that virtual environment. So ls, now this is the virtual environment it has created. Sample project, the name of the project, dash this alphanumeric sample file name, okay, folder name basically. And then if I just go over there, you will be able to see that in this folder it has created this bin lib pyenv.cfg src. Okay, and in this lib folder it has installed the request package and this site packages, and here it has install the request package over here. Okay, let me clear the screen. Okay, so this is how it creates the virtual environment for us automatically and install the request package. Now what happened next? Let me just clear the screen over here as well. I'm in the sample project. Now what it does as well, in this folder we were having only main.py and readme.md file only. Now it has created a pip file and pipfile.lock. Okay, it's equivalent to those who are coming from npm, those who are coming from node.js background, it is equivalent to package.json or package.lock file, right? Now it has pip file and pipfile.lock. Okay, now as soon as I install the request package, it creates the pip file, and it mentioned the request package over here with the star pattern, means install the latest version of request, because I did not mention the request package version, right? So it automatically creates this file, adds this entry over here. Now there are two types of packages, dev packages and runtime packages. Runtime packages, which is necessary to run a program, basically without which the program won't run. But dev packages are those which is necessary for development. Like if you are writing a unit test, or you are linting something, you're formatting your code, etc. All those kind of packages comes in the dev packages. So we can install packages explicitly in the dev packages section. Suppose you are done with this command, you want to install more than you want to install again some other package. So I have to type in the command python-m pipenv install, and then type in -d. -d is to add this entry over this dev packages. Okay, and pytest is the package I want to install. Now what it does, it installs the package in the same site packages folder over here. Type in like ls, you will get to see that pytest is available over here, right? Pytest. Now it has created an entry over here, pytest equal to star in the dev packages section, because we have used the -d in the as an option. Okay, let me clear this screen. Now this is how very easy to manage dependencies. We can uninstall as well using the uninstall command instead of install command. It is very easy. We can also mention the specific version using the equal to after the package name, and then it will install the specific version of that package into the site packages folder. Okay, now what next? We are done with this installation. I want to run the program, right? I'm okay, pipenv makes me happy in terms of virtual environment, in terms of dependencies, but ultimately I have to run the code, right? Now in order to run the code, there are multiple approach to run the code, either by the command or either by the VS code. We will first see the command. Okay, so what command I need to write? Normally those people who do not have any background of using the dependency management, etc., what we normally do, we type in python space main.py, right, to run a particular Python program, right? So how do we achieve that in case of Pipenv? In earlier videos, we have seen that we created a virtual environment, then we activated that virtual environment. Now, how do we activate that virtual environment in this case? For that, we have a command pipenv shell command. Okay, with this command, the shell will be activating the pipenv created virtual environment, and then we can run the simple Python commands over there. So if I hit and type in enter, then it simply selected that environment, sample project. Okay, now this shell is now simply using the virtual environment that it has created now. So I can simply type in python main.py, okay, to execute the program, because it is going to run the Python program by using this virtual environment, because I have used pipenv shell command. Now if I type in python space main.py, it will show the output user id is 1, because it makes a call and then prints the output. Similar to this, there are different approach to run this. Now I am still sitting in this virtual environment because I have this in this bracket. Okay, if you are not sure that whether you are sitting in the virtual environment or not, you can check this whether it is present or not. If you want to exit from this virtual environment, basically from the shell, type in exit. Okay, I'm currently exit of it. Okay, I'm done with the exit. Now, in order to run the same program main.py, this program, without even selecting or activating the virtual environment, there is one more command, okay, which is pipenv run command. Here we do not have to switch to the virtual environment, it simply runs by using that. Okay, pipenv run python main.py. okay, so it simply runs the program without even switching to the virtual environment, but it ultimately makes use of the packages which gets installed into this virtual environment. Okay, I hope this is clear till now. Now what happened, like, I sometimes people are not used to run commands in order to run the program. They want to use the VS Code provided tools to run the program. Now, how do we use VS Code to run the program? Now, if you see in this VS Code is showing this yellow line, okay, saying that, okay, I do not know about this request package because I am not using the correct Python interpreter or correct virtual environment. In that particular virtual environment, request package is missing. Okay, so how I want to make the VS Code happy, for that you just have to click on Control Shift P, and then you have to type in select interpreter. It will come up on top and click on this. Now in this list, you have to select that particular newly created virtual environment by pipenv. Just go to the bottom, you can select whatever bottom, or just scroll up down and see where is the pipenv created virtual environment. Okay, now this looks like that, right? Sample project ng. If I'm here, type in pwd sample project ng, right? So this is the virtual environment I need to select. Okay, select this. Now as soon as I select it, VS Code is happy. It gets to know that, okay, this virtual environment has this request package already available, and I am good to run this program. Now VS Code is ready to run this program. For that, just click on this run and debug button and run and debug. Now your output will, so I already put a breakpoint over here, so it actually stops over here because it runs in the debug mode, and simply you can simply click on this step over. I'm able to see the response. Okay, you can simply debug it and then click on this play button, continue button, and output is here. So this way we can run the same program using VS Code as well. Okay, let us see a few more commands of pipenv. Now there are a few commands. First is check command, which is used to check whether there is any vulnerabilities in the current Python project or not. We can type in pipenv check. Okay, it will simply returns whether it is like vulnerable or not, packages are having any vulnerabilities or not. Okay, now clear this. Now one more command, pipenv graph command. Using this command, we can see the dependencies graph and how the dependencies are listed and how they are dependent on each other, etc. So this is a handy command to check all those dependency graph. Okay, now one more command after this, pipenv Now, in order to generate requirement file from the pipenv, whatever dependencies you have installed, those gets entered into the pip file. But if you want to generate the requirement file, then we can type in pipenv requirements command. Okay. So this particular, this particular content, we can make use of it in the requirements file in order to actually go back to the legacy mode and run it in some other way. Okay. So there is one more command that is, I already talked about, to uninstall any dependency. So we can try removing the dependency, python fnm pipenv uninstall. Suppose we want to uninstall request package, uninstall request. Now what it does, it will remove the request package from the site packages, basically virtual environment that it has created, and it will also be updating the pip file and pipfile.lock as well. As soon as I type in, if you able to see that request entry over here has removed, and it has removed it from the pipfile.lock, and as well as the VS Code is now unhappy because the request package is no longer present in the virtual environment. Okay. Last command in this series is pipenv. If you are not sure where my virtual environment is, and I have given you the path, although, but if you do not want to, like if you forget about it, so don't worry, you have one more command, pipenv hyphen hyphen venv, which is just to have a lookup where the virtual environment is present. Okay, for this particular current project, pipenv dash dash venv, it will simply show the project that is virtual env path. So all the packages that you are installing with this pipenv command is getting installed within this folder. Okay. That's it for this video. I hope you understand the concept of pipenv very well and you will make use of it in your upcoming project. So thank you so much. Until then, goodbye. And if you like this video, do put up your comment in the comment section and share this video to your friends, colleagues to understand the concept of pipenv. I hope you will be waiting for another video. We are going to come up soon. Thank you. Bye.